It's been a while, about 1,400 years, since the Colosseum last hosted any bloody spectacles. Since then, earthquakes, scavengers, time and grime have taken their toll. In a corridor off-limits to the public for decades, a project to clear away the accumulated dirt and dust has uncovered patches of red plaster dating back to a major repair work done on the Colosseum after a massive fire in 217 AD. Despite what you may have seen in the movies, ancient monuments and statues were painted in the most vivid of colors, and the internal passageways of the Colosseum were, in the words of one of the archaeologists here, in technicolor. Archaeologists long suspected this masterpiece of Roman architecture was not monochrome, says Colosseum director Rossella Rea.
Non avevamo mai trovato le testimonianze sul posto.
We had never found proof, she says, but thanks to this simple cleaning work, we now know that not only the lower parts of the corridor, but also the upper areas had decorations.
Abbiamo la certezza.
Red, green, blue, and white would have been the colors of choice, but it wasn't just the interior decorators who left their mark here. Some unknown fan scrawled some naughty bits on the walls. The phallus symbolized fertility and prosperity in Roman times. Someone else left a now faded drawing of a crown of laurels given to the victors in the arena. This writing is not an advertisement for wine, but more likely the abbreviation of Vindici, a common name for gladiators. Everything uncovered here, restorer Alessandro Danesi tells me, is a clue to the past. Even dirt is an important indicator, he says, of use, of neglect, of every object's historical phases. And in this case, dirt that has concealed the Colosseum's not just blood-spattered, but also colorful past. Ben Wedeman, CNN, Rome.